वेलकम टू साइंस ईजी टेक चैनल नथिंग मेड ईजी इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट मोड फॉर ग्रुप डेटा बिफोर मूविंग ऑन टू द टॉपिक इफ यू आर न्यू टू साइंस ईजी टेक चैनल जस्ट टेक अ मोमेंट टू सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल एंड ऑल्सो टू प्रेस द नोटिफिकेशन बेल आइकॉन इन ऑर्डर टू गेट कनेक्टेड विथ अवर लेटेस्ट अपडेट्स Let's see the contents what we are going to discuss in this part 9 video, that is mode for group data. Already I have discussed mean median for group data. If you have not watched my previous videos, I have given the link in description box. Please go and watch it. So in this video we are going to discuss about mode for group data. So under ungrouped data, raw data, we have already discussed. In group data, we have two types. What are they? Discrete series and continuous series. So first we will see mode for discrete series. Then we will see mode for continuous series. Central tendency measure mode. What is mode? Already I have explained what is mode in my previous video. So mode is nothing but it is the value which has the highest frequency. It is denoted by Z. It is the value which has the highest frequency and it is denoted by Z. Let's see example for discrete series. Mode for group data in discrete series. Find the mode for the following data. See here wages, number of employees. 150, 3 employees are there. 160, 16 employees are there, 178 employees are there, 180, 20 employees are there, 206 employees are there, 222 employees are there. See, here the most occurring frequency what? It is 20. So, here the most occurring frequency is 20. So, this wages is nothing but X value and number of employees is F value. Okay. So, wages is nothing but X value. So, here number of employees F is there? No. So, here 20 is the most occurring frequency. Most of the employees are getting the wages 180 rupees. So, the highest occurring frequency is 20 and the corresponding X value, that is 180, is your mode. So, 180 is your mode. So, the Z value is 180. The Z value is 180. That is the mode is 180. Okay. So see here, Z is the most occurring frequency, which is 20. The most occurring frequency already I told, that is 20. Okay. What is the corresponding X value? The corresponding X value is 180. So, 180 is having the highest frequency, that is 20. So, what is your mode? Z is equal to 180. Next, we will move on to mode for group data, that is continuous series. In case of continuous frequency table, you have a specific formula to calculate the mode. Okay, what is that formula? Like in median, we have seen no. For continuous data, a specific formula. Similarly, in mode also, there is a specific formula to calculate for continuous data or continuous series. Let us see what it is. So, Z is equal to L plus F minus F1 into W. The dot means into, okay, multiplication, okay, divided by 2F minus F1 minus F2. I repeat the formula. Z is equal to L plus F minus F1 into W divided by 2F minus F1 minus F2. So, what is modal class? Modal class is the class which has the highest frequency. Okay. Then, if you identify the modal class, the corresponding X value will be there. No. So, there you have to see lower limit. See lower limit. What is the lower limit of the modal class? Then W, width of the modal class. Width of the modal class, how you will be calculating? Upper limit minus lower limit of the modal class gives the width of the modal class. Then F, corresponding frequency of the modal class. Then F1, frequency of class just before the modal class. Then F2, frequency of the class just after the modal class. Let me make it more clear by explaining with an example. Let's see the example. Calculate the mode for the following data. Okay, so this data is continuous data. So wages, workers, 100 to 120, 6 workers, 120 to 140, 13 workers, 140 to 160, 17 workers, 160 to 180, 8 workers, and 180 to 200, 6 workers. Okay, ma? So let me make it more clear. See here, 17 is the most occurring frequency. Okay, 17 is the most occurring frequency. Next, what is the lower limit? The lower limit is 140. So L, the lower limit is 140. Okay, so the lower limit is what? 140. So you can calculate lower limit 140. Okay, next, what is the upper limit is 160. So I told upper limit minus lower limit gives what? Upper limit minus lower limit gives your width. So 160 minus 140 is equal to how much? 20. So 20 is your width. Okay, next we will move on to F1. What is F1? F1 is nothing but the class just before the highest frequency. Okay, before the modal class. Okay, that is highest frequency occurring is called as modal class. So here 17 is the highest frequency occurring. So this is called as modal class. So the class or frequency just before the modal class is your F1. Then what is F2? F2 is nothing but the class just after the modal class. The frequency of class just after the modal class is your F2. Okay, so everything I will once again summarize for you. Modal class, class which contains highest frequency. The highest frequency containing class in the previous example is 17. Modal class 140 to 160. W, width of the modal class, that is 160 minus 140 is equal to 20. Then F, frequency of the modal class 17. F1, frequency just before the modal class is 13. Then F2, frequency just after the modal class is 8. So now we can substitute in the formula. Already I discussed about formula. Z is equal to L plus F minus F1 into W divided by 2F minus F1 minus F2. So Z is equal to 140 plus 17 minus 13 into 20 divided by 2 into 17 minus 13 minus 8. Okay, ma? So here L plus F minus F1. What is F? 17. What is F1? 13. So 17 minus 13 into W. What is W? Upper limit minus lower limit of the modal class is 20. So 20. Okay, your lower limit is 140. You have substituted already. Divided by 2 into F is 2 into 17 minus F1 is 13 minus F2 is 8. So after substitution, you will get 140. Plus 17 minus 13, how much? 4 into 20 divided by 2 into 17, how much? 34 minus 13 minus 8. So when you simplify it, 140 plus 4 into 20, 80. 34 minus 13 minus 8 gives 13. So 140 plus 80 by 13 gives 6.15. So the answer is 146.15. The answer is 146.15. Okay. So hope it's clear for you all. So there is a question for viewers. Calculate the mode for the following data. So this data is discrete data. So by seeing yourself, you can tell answer for this. Okay. So one more thing, calculate the mode for the following continuous data. For this, you have to substitute in the formula what I have discussed and post your answers in comment section. Hope this video is clear for you all. Still, if you have any doubts, please feel free to post your doubts in the comments box so that I can clarify it. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up, share and subscribe to Science Easy Tech channel. My previous videos link I have given in description box. If you have not watched it, please go and watch it. Keep supporting to Science Easy Tech channel.